Hello, motorsports fan. Lee Kraft here, the Monday Morning Racer, and in this installment of Monday Morning Racer on location, got some drifting action for you. This is the first time I ever went to a drift. I went Friday night of a three-day event at Lake Erie Speedway in Erie, Pennsylvania, and I'm glad I went on Friday night. The guys that were drifting were just kind of having some fun, so you're going to see drifting action with cars going out by themselves and some out there with four other cars. It was a pretty good night. I enjoyed the night out there and the action I was able to see, and I hope you enjoy the action that I got on camera for you that you are about to see right here on Monday Morning Racer. Hey, hit the like button for me, drop a comment, subscribe to the channel, and remember, you can find Monday Morning Racer right here on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Till next time, God bless and keep the pedal to the metal.
Oh. Thank you. Monday morning racer here in the pits at Lake Erie Speedway for a drift event. Caught up with AJ and Dave of the Sinister Drift Team. Guys, look, you've got some great cars with some great patina, but it took a lot of time for it to get that way. Well, actually a short amount of time. Tell us the story on these cars.
So 2 years ago, our garage burned down. Obviously, these two cars were in them. Me and my little brother were working on his car, turned around, and the place was on fire. It was an electrical issue. So, like I said, we just kind of had to stand there, watch the place burn down. We tried to put it out, but it didn't happen. Next day, the landlord basically told us we had 6 hours to clear the place out before he had to board it up because the city condemned it. And made a post on Facebook, like 20-some people showed up, went to clear the place out, started taking tools, whatever we could. And basically the front of the roof to get out of the shop was collapsed, so we had to walk over a bunch of debris. We didn't know if we could get the cars out. So he tried to start his car. His didn't start, which was actually an issue that was before the fire. We just didn't think about it because of, well, the fire. So I kind of yelled at him, and then I was like, all right, like, what are you gonna do, burn the place down? And so I went to start my car, and my car is all like simplified on switches. And like, I literally hit the switches and the car started. It just wouldn't idle because it melted a vacuum hose. So car was on jack stands. We literally jacked it up with tools we had in the building, jacked it up. And there's actually a video, like, it went viral for a while of me driving the car out of the shop. And this started like 2 days later because he remembered what was wrong with it. We did lose three cars, right? Three. Yeah, my buddy's girlfriend's Miata, a 7 Series BMW I had, and my little brother's Z that he bought 3 weeks prior, so that sucked. But yeah, so we kind of just like threw them back together, put new glass in them, and been driving them ever since. His is pretty much the way it was from the fire. Mine, I blew up a year later, now has an LS in it. I've kind of gone through and redone a bunch of stuff, but yeah.
What you see is what you get.
Yeah, I mean, definitely the cars have a lot of character. Yeah. I've seen a lot of people, you know, it has turned their head, caught their eye, caught my eye. Great story, and that you're still running them. Now, you mentioned you got an LS here. What about the other particular parameters to the setup we're looking at?
For my car or his car?
Go ahead, both of them.
You do yours first.
This is a stock 5.0. It's all factory wiring, factory computer. It had a clutch safety switch issue during the fire, so that was obviously in the chaos. We didn't realize that that was why the car wouldn't run, but a couple days later, once I remembered that I had to jump the starter solenoid to crank, so after that, it was pretty much ready to go. Change the oil in it, put glass in it, and bring it out.
Okay, so what about yours?
During the fire, it was stock E36, 320, like 2.5 liter. Now it's an LQ9 setup out of an Escalade 256. All the suspension stuff, hydro. Just like pretty basic for even for a V8, just to keep it running and keep it going. Doesn't make any crazy power. It's all stock, like engine wise, but it's enough for what we needed for. Basically, I kind of fell in the swap fell in my lap. I bought a car that had it for dirt cheap and took everything out, put it in this. So, but yeah, nothing. We try to keep it simple, drive as much as we can.
Well, guys, look, I'm glad that you were able to have some redemption out of that fire story.
Yeah.
That these cars have been through hell but came back. And to you, the Sinister Drift Team, hope you do well in this event, and thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm.